Now let's take a closer look at ski areas in Colorado. One of the layers that I have here in my GIS is a layer called the Continental Divide. It's in yellow, but of course, as you know from the previous exercise, you can change the width of any of these symbols. You can change the color of any of these symbols. So I've got it in yellow so I can see a little bit better. As I look at the Continental Divide winding through the state, I notice that, for example, the rivers flow on either side of the Continental Divide. So if I turn off the shaded relief for a moment, I can see, for example, up here in the Steamboat Springs ski area, that this river on the left side or the west side of the Continental Divide is flowing west. This river on the right side or on the east side of the Continental Divide is flowing east. So one of the other things that you could do that's powerful is to teach the relationship of rivers to the Continental Divide. Colorado, being a high in elevation state, is the source of many great river systems of our country. The Rio Grande, for example, starts over here in the mountains in the southwest part of the state and flows down through the San Luis Valley and out into New Mexico. The Colorado River starts up here in the north central part of the state, flows to the west and out into Utah. The reason why the Continental Divide sort of makes this westward jog in here is that this mountain valley right here that I'm pointing to, called North Park in Colorado, this is the birthplace of the Platte, specifically the North Platte River. So in here is the North Platte. It's flowing into Wyoming, but then it makes a big bend up to Casper and down into Nebraska to join the South Platte, which is over here in the northeast part of Colorado. The reason why this boundary takes a jog to the west is because it has to go around that so that the North Platte can actually get out to the Gulf of Mexico eventually. If we look at the Denver metropolitan area here and Fort Collins, Pooter School District, Fort Collins, Greeley, Loveland area, this is all drained into the South Platte River, which flows out just about in the northeastern corner of the state. Well, what about the southeastern part of the state? This is all drained by the mighty Arkansas River drainage, which starts up here in the central part of Colorado, flows down to Pueblo here, and then out into Kansas. So taking a look at river systems in relationship to the Continental Divide is another powerful thing you can do as an introductory component also to the whole discussion of ski areas. Because as we'll see in the next segment, ski areas are clustered near the Continental Divide for various reasons.